Hello guys, welcome to Algorithms Made Easy. My name is Rajat and today we will be discussing the question gas station. In this question, we are given n gas stations along a circular route where the amount of gas at the ith station is gas of I. Now, we have a car with unlimited gas tank and it costs cost of I of gas to travel from ith station to the next I plus 1 station. We begin the journey with an empty tank at one of the gas stations. Given are the two integer arrays gas and cost, and we need to return the starting index if we can travel around the circuit once in the clockwise direction, otherwise we return minus 1. Now, if there is a solution existing for this particular problem, it is guaranteed to be unique. So, in the first example, as we can see that if we started from the index 3, we could have covered all the gas stations. And in example 2, we cannot go through all the gas stations. So that way we return minus 1. We'll see the conditions on when we return minus 1 and when we can produce the output. So let's first understand this particular problem. So this is the example given to us. We have two arrays in which first array is the gas array and the second is the cost array. Let's take each point as A, B, C, D, E. And as we know that it is a circular circuit, we'll define a circular circuit for us. It has 5 points in this circular circuit. Each point has some amount of gas that we can get from this particular point. Now, in order to move from one point to another, there is a cost associated with that. So, if we need to move from A to B, the cost is 3. If we move from B to C, it is 4. C to D is 5, and so on. The problem is, we are in a car with zero tank, and we can start from any of these particular indexes. So, let's first see what is a valid and an invalid movement looks like. So if you are at any index, in this case, if we started from index B, then amount of fuel that we get from this particular index is 2. So we fuel our car with this particular gas. We now have 2 units of gas with us and we can only move in the clockwise direction. So we move from B to C. Now, the cost associated with moving from B to C is 4 and we do not have that much amount of fuel. So this particular movement is invalid movement. Whenever the fuel in the tank minus the distance or the cost is less than 0, we cannot make that particular move because we do not have that amount of fuel with us. Now, with this thing, we also get to know about one more concept that if the total amount of gas minus the total amount of cost that we have is less than 0. That means the sum of cost is greater than sum of gas. There is no way that we can cover the whole circuit because at some point or the other, we will run into a condition where we do not have ample amount of fuel to move to the next point. We will discuss that condition too thoroughly in later part of this video. Moving on, we know that the answer to this problem is that we start from point D, or in this case, the index 3. How does that run look like? Let's see that. So if we start from the index D, we fill our tank with the fuel that is here at the point D. We take our car to point E using 1 unit of the fuel. Again, fuel our car with the fuel present at point E. Move to A, use 2 units of fuel. Refuel our car, move to B. Use 3 units of fuel, refuel again, move to C by using 4 units of fuel, filling our car to 3 units of fuel, and lastly, moving again to D and having no fuel at the end when we reach D. Now, this is acceptable. We were able to move through the whole circuit without anywhere running into a condition where we do not have enough fuel to move to the next point. So that becomes our answer. Now, how does this answer came into existence? How can we find out that the point D is the point that we need to start with? So let's see that into a tabular form and with all the values, the point, gas and cost associated with each point that we have. At the end, there is a row which is gas minus cost, which for the explanation purpose will hold the value of gas minus cost for that particular index. We'll start off with thinking that it is the 0th index, or in this case, the point A is the point from where we start off. At this point, we get the gas minus cost as minus 2. So this becomes our temporary sum that we have. Now, if the sum is minus 2, that means when we reach this particular index. The fuel that we have right now is in negative. That means we lose fuel when we reach this particular point, and it doesn't make sense for us to start from this particular point. Whenever this temporary sum is less than zero, we move that into the total sum. The total sum will at the end hold the value of total gas minus total cost, which we have discussed earlier, that if at the end we came to know that the total amount of gas that we can get from all this point and the total cost it takes to move around the circuit are different, the cost is greater, then there is no way that we can move around the circuit because we do not have any extra gas with us. We are starting with an empty tank and we need to go around this circuit which has a cost associated with it, with the only gas that is present along the way. So we are sure that the position is not the zeroth index, the position can be the next index. So we increment the position to the next index. Now we see that if B can be the point from where we can start off. So we see that the gas minus cost in this case is minus 2. We add that into our sum. We again see that the sum is negative. So that cannot be the point from where we can start off with. We again move this sum to the total. We increment the position. And similarly for the point C. Now, when we reach point D, this is the first time that we get the sum as 3. That means when we are at this particular point, there will be an addition to the amount of fuel that we can get. So the sum is positive and we can now move ahead with this particular additional fuel to the next point, and the next point also gives us additional fuels, that is 3. So the sum now becomes 6. The sum is still greater than 0. So the last position where we got the sum as positive was position 3. Total up till that point was minus 6. From that point till the end, the sum is 6. So the total sum now becomes sum plus the total, which is minus 6 plus 6 equals to 0. Now this total, as we discussed, is nothing but sum of gas minus sum of cost. And as this value is 0, that means that the total amount of gas that we have and the total amount of cost balances each other out, and we have enough gas to circuit around all the points. So this means whatever value is there in the position variable is the answer that we need to return, which is position 3. So this is how we come to know that if we started from index 3, we were able to go around the whole circuit. This might be a little bit confusing at first, so let's see this from another angle. We still have this points table with us, in which we have all the points associated with their gas cost and gas minus cost value. If we plot the value of sum at each particular index on a graph, we see that the value remains below zero in point A, B and C, and it is the first time that it rises above the zero value at point D, and from that point it continuously is in the positive side. So the first point after which the sum remains positive is the point that we can start our journey from. Now whether we need to return this position or not all depends on that total variable, because if we do not have the perfect balance between gas and cost, then we cannot move around the circuit. So that is a precondition. You can have two different loops to solve this problem. First, to check the total, and the second, to find out the sum. It will be much more clear in the coding part. Now, there are certain cases in this problem as well. So if there are more number of points in the circuit, and for now, let's add two more points, F and G. The F still gives us a positive gas minus cost. So the sum still rises above, but the point G uses the amount of fuel that is with us. So the sum value goes down, but the sum value is still not below zero. So still the first point from where the sum value is not below zero is D, and we return this. Now suppose there is one more value. The gas is 1, the cost is 10. The gas minus cost is minus 9. In this case, the value of sum drops to minus 1. And if you do sum of gas minus sum of cost for this particular problem up till A to G, you will find out that the cost is much greater than the amount of gas that we have. So we will directly return minus 1. There won't be any position that we will be returning in this particular example. And again, if we come across one more point which gives us 7 quantity of gas after we visit it, it brings our sum to the positive side. So in this case, what you think will be the point after which the sum never goes in the negative side or always stay on the positive side? If your guess was point I, then you are correct. If we started from point I, we can go around this whole circuit without anywhere running into a condition where we are stuck. And in this case, we'll return the index of I as the answer. Now, that's all for the explanation part, and it's time for you to try and code this particular approach with the understanding that you get from this video. If you are stuck, you can always come back to the video and see how we are solving it. If you're still having doubt, then keep watching this video. Now it's time to code this particular approach. So as discussed, we will have three variables and we will define those. Now, we know that we need to iterate over the gas array and the cost array. The length of the two will be the same, so we'll iterate over those. We need to find out the temporary sum that we will be getting. The sum will be the value of gas that we have at this particular index minus the cost to move from this particular index to the next index. Now, we discussed that if anywhere the sum goes below zero, that means if we start from this point, the amount of fuel that we are using is less than zero, and that is not possible. It should be more than zero. So we add that value into our total because we need this total sum in order to find out whether this particular gas and cost values are feasible enough to go around the circuit or not. Then we make the sum to zero because we have already calculated this, and the position will say that this index is not the position we can start with. Let's assume that it will be the next position. Remember that we are not incrementing the position. We are making it index plus 1. Because as we see that there may be a condition that it is continuously going upward for 3 to 4 indexes and then suddenly it goes down. The last example in the video that we discussed. Now, as in the example 1, we see that the sum is continuously going up, so there may be some value in the sum that is not been added into the total. So we add that, and at the end we just simply check if the total is greater than 0. If it is greater than 0, then for sure that we can return the position. That means the amount of gas is greater than or equals to amount of cost, so it will be total greater than equals to 0. If that's the case, then we return the position, otherwise we return minus 1. So now we are done with the coding part. Let's try to run this code for all the sample test cases. So it ran successfully. Let's submit this. So it got submitted successfully. The time complexity of this particular approach is O of n, as we are doing only one iteration. Well, the space complexity is O of 1 because we are not using any extra space. I hope this video helped you in understanding the problem. If you like this video, do like, share and subscribe to the channel. Do let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one.